Hello everyone. I believe you're ready for this class. Okay, so we are into the economics class for SS2 students. Alright, today we'll be treating the concept of national income or national income concept. They mean the same thing. So we'll be considering what national income actually talks about, and we see their uses, the effects on the economy. So firstly, let's see the meaning of national income, the meaning or the definition. Okay, I believe you must have heard the word national income before, being at this level. Yes, you must have heard national income before. So national income is the monetary value of all goods and services. You see that? It is the monetary value of all goods and services produced within a country. What does that mean? Every economy has economic activity. Or let me say, every economy involves in economic activities. And the result of this economic activity is that they produce goods and services. So the production of goods and services is what we call economic activities. All right. Now all these activities, or all these goods and services produced, are being valued in monetary terms. So that's what national income actually talks about, the valuation of goods and services in monetary terms is what national income talks about. I believe that's clear. For instance, if all the goods and services produced in Nigeria for the year 1905, if all the goods and services worth 1 billion naira, so that's the monetary value for the goods and services produced in Nigeria for that year. I hope you get that now. So that's just the simple definition. It is the monetary value of all goods and services produced within a country. And take note, over a given period of time, and it's usually a year. So you are familiar with that terminologies. Okay, it is plus net income from abroad. So, you know, we export some of our products or services outside the country. So, income generated from these goods or services exported, they are added to the what? National income. Because it says plus net income from abroad. So, it includes revenue generated from our sales abroad. Alright, let's move forward. It also includes the income accruable to all factors of production. The national income is different from income of the government. Yes, take note of this. The income of the government is entirely different from national income. Exactly. Now, let's see the difference. The national income is the value of all economic activity. The value, that is the monetary value of all economic activity of the country, is the national income. Are you getting it? Why the government income is revenue raised by the government through taxation and borrowings or fees. You know, the major source of government revenue is taxation. That's the major source of government revenue. You understand? So, government revenue is what government income rather is the revenue that is derived from what taxation, from borrowing, from fees. Even they could get grants from other country or external bodies. You understand? So that is government income. But the national income is the monetary value of all economic activity. Please take note of the two. They are different. All right. Now, let's see the major concept of national income. The major concept of national income. Now, no matter the when you are dealing with national income, you must talk about the GDP, which we call the gross domestic product. That's the full meaning. And you have the gross national product, the net national product, excuse me, the personal income, the disposable income, the net domestic product, and income per capita. Seven major. So let's consider them one after the other and see where how far we'll go. The gross domestic product is defined as the total money value of all goods and services produced in a country at a particular period of time. Yes, that's the total monetary value of all goods and services produced in a country. That's what we call the GDP. So when you hear GDP, just know that it's the total monetary value. That is all goods produced in a country at a particular period of time. So that's the GDP. And you know, GDP is the major catalyst used to measure the growth rate of the economy. Yes, you can't know how developed an economy is without considering the GDP of such economy, because growth is a dependent of goods and services produced in an economy, or better say, growth is a function of goods and services produced in an economy. So the higher the level of goods and services produced, the higher the GDP, and it tells on the economy, because the productive capacity of an economy must be on the high side for such economy to develop. So that's basically what the GDP talks about: the monetary value of all goods produced, all goods and services produced in an economy. Now we go to the gross national product. Gross national product is the total monetary value of goods and services produced by an economy during a specified period of time, usually a year. It includes all earnings of citizens of a given country and investment income of citizens abroad. So this one includes revenue from abroad. That's the gross national product. It includes revenue from abroad. So it excludes the investment of foreigner from calculation of national income accounts, and no allowance is made for depreciation. So depreciation are not included in the gross national product. So we have others. Let's consider, let's see the mathematical formation. Now the GNP is GDP. You know what the GDP means? All monetary value of goods and services, okay, plus your net income from abroad. I told you that it includes the income from abroad, that is the economic activity outside the country, you know, while exportation takes place. So you include the monetary value in your GNP, but the GDP does not actually include net income from abroad. So get the difference clear. So you have GNP equals GDP plus net income from abroad, which means you have GNP equals GDP plus exports minus imports. X is for exports, as you have M is for imports. You understand? So if you go through your textbook and you try to read further on your own, you'll be given mathematical figures. So you subtract your export from your income, then you add it to your GDP. So that's that on for this moment. So you take your time and explain on your own what national net national product means, personal income, disposable income. Read further for the next class. Next class I'll be explaining all this again, but read further and prepare it for them, and enjoy yourself. So do take care of yourself. Bye.